I'm sending you to tell your people that I have a plan for them. For Ohima Mercy to be disciplined and still go according to what God has called me. I have that assurance that God will never fail me.
I agree. I love your outfit.
Thank you. It's designed by Udin.
Oh,
I'm being sponsored
right.
by Udin, and right. I love the outfit so
I think
much.
You're wearing
I love
it.
The material.
You're wearing it beautifully.
Yes.
What's that around your neck?
Tahila Prayer Shawl.
You know, Tahila has become a household name.
Exactly.
It's become a brand, and so much that is important that we take a moment.
Yes.
If not for time, we'll be having coffee and having this discussion. What? How did Tahila start?
Tahila started when I was in a plane going to California from Virginia. And then mostly when I'm in the plane, I have my quiet time. I pray quietly. And then the Lord said, you have done a lot for me, my daughter. But there is one thing. I need people to dine with me. I need people to dine with me. And I, Jehovah, I'll come into their mess. And I was like, Father, which part of it that I have to do to bring people to dine with you? And the Lord said, I need you to bring people together to worship. And the Lord revealed to me that it is only worship that he comes in our midst. And when we pray, the Lord said his angels to go and send forth the answers. But it is only the time when you enter into the time of worship that you see God himself coming to dine with us. And so when I got the revelation 2013, I called my team, and then we started the first one. It was amazing. It was a holiday. It was Thursday. Amazingly, the next day rather was the holiday. And Thursday was a working day. And I'm telling you, the number of people that came to National Theatre was amazing. So we realized that God wants to do something with us. So we have to hold on 2014, and then 2015 we started it. And I'm telling you, we have lots of testimonies. God is doing miracles so much under this atmosphere. And when you ask Ohima Mercy, what do you do? I don't know. But I have allowed God to do his own thing. And surely, he has never failed.
I'm curious about the name Tahila.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean?
It's another form of worship.
Okay.
And this kind of worship goes beyond the kind of worship we always do in the church, where we hold our phone and lift up our hands and make it seem like we are worshiping. This one, you lay off everything. You even don't want to look around you of whatever is going on, because you have a business with the Lord. And that, so you enter into that kind of worship, what Hannah did. And for a prophet to tell Hannah, you are drunk, means that kind of worship goes beyond everything that you are going through. It goes beyond the problems you are going through. It goes beyond the depression, whatever. You want the devil to know that you have taken part of me, but I have a God that is capable and able to do everything. Yes, I've seen what you are doing, but I know when I enter into worship, God is able to do something.
I told you, if you're missing God is morning, able to do something. You're missing out on a lot. I know that it is always backed by the Holy Spirit, but have you had challenges?
Yes. Worship. Sometimes with our preparation, here and there. Anytime there's worship, the devil brings up so many things. Oh yeah, I hate to worship too much. Because it allows God to be God. God will never worship himself. He needs us to give him that food. So anytime you see worship happening, the devil will also show up. But one thing that I believe is prayer will bring the hand of the devil down.
Amen. How are you able to put all together financially?
I sacrifice a lot when it comes to Tahila experience. I believe the Lord allowed Abraham. God pushed Abraham to sacrifice so much to the point that only his son, God said, sacrifice that one. And during that time, God made Abraham understand that I am able and capable. The God that works, he is the impossibility specialist.